Hey guys, I'm Izia and welcome to another episode. Today we're going to be looking at the multi-directional clutch. Last episode we showed the just the clutch by itself, which you know, you can essentially turn it on and off to prevent power from going through to a source. This one, however, is a little bit different. It essentially lets you to direct power flow, similar to the way that a bevel does, but essentially you can use the power, well, the redstone levels to determine which direction the power output is going towards. So I already got a little setup over there for it. I didn't want you guys to have to go through all that. You'll know why later. Anyway, this is essentially the multi-directional. So two base panels, two red, two X gear, four shaft units. That's pretty easy. It essentially has five outputs and one input. So it works like most radiocraft machines, where the input is away from you, and the so see like that. As you can see, it's already started to work. If we right click on it, we see we've got 15 slots. So these are correspond to the power levels. So as you can see, we've got a lever, some redstone here, and when you send a power, redstone signal through redstone. Every single meter or every square, it essentially loses one power level. So when we go to here, we can see that it's got 15. So if you were if you had one piece of redstone in the way, that would be 15. And as you can see, if we can just click on it, it changes the color. If we look at the angular transducer on it, you can see it's got color sided codes. So these correspond to the colors here. As you can see here, we've got two switches. So if I was to put a lever here, the redstone that would be imparted to this clutch would be actually a power level of 16. If it was here, it'd be a power level of 15, because it would be 16 minus 1, 15. And so this one here is a power level, was it, that was, I think I've got this right. 16 there, 15, so that one should be 14 and 13, I think. I might have this one wrong, it's close enough, we'll soon figure it out. So we've got three outputs on this, essentially, that we're using. One going this direction, one actually going down, and up and across, up. One going down that goes all the way through the middle to this machine here. And then we've got one to the side, and one comes out and then off to the side. So we just need to set the colors and wait until to see which one's color. So right now, no power signal is making the output at the bottom work, which is probably this color blue. So we're going to leave it like that. So when the clutch isn't receiving any power, it will automatically output down below. So we should be able to, let's see if we can get these colors correct. So yellow is one and pink is the other. So let's cycle these through to pink, and let's see if this one's right. Okay, so 14 power level is 2 away, so 1, 2, that equals the power level 14, and it's now set to output on the pink side, which is this side, as you can see, pink, and because this is 1, which one? Have I got this one right? I gotta make sure I got this right. Okay, yep. So this one is 14. If this one gets turned on, it should be 15. Oh, I mean one less, sorry, 13. So did I say it was yellow? Yes, it was. And now, see, this one here is 13. Because it's one more away from the 14 one. And now we're outputting to this side. So as you can see, this whole thing is powered by four steam engines. So it's 512 radians at 128 newton meters total, which is the equivalent of a gasoline engine. So essentially what we're doing here is we can power three objects, not all at once, right? But we can essentially with the flick of a switch, since with a flick of a switch, we can essentially power three machines with only one power source, which was pretty decent. As you can see here, we've got the rock smelter here. We've got a gearbox set up to it, so it's, what's it, downgrading the torque. We can flick this switch and go, actually, I want to power my furnace instead at the power of four steam engines. Or I can be like, hey, I want to power the centrifuge with the power of four steam engines. So instead of making essentially, what is it, 12, sorry. Instead of making 12 steam engines and having another set of, I think that's 9 transfer junctions and another 3 bevels just for each of these individual machines, we can essentially use a multi-directional clutch to divert power in the direction we want. We could have use a bevel to do the same thing, but each time you'd have to manually do it. With the redstone thing, you could essentially use a clocks to on and off them, so you could essentially have some machines powered sometimes and other times have the other machines powered, which is pretty neat. This also lets you essentially run an extractor only off one engine. If you know the extractor, one of the stages you require 8,192 radiance, and it also requires 512 torque at one of the other stages. So if you wanted to power all four stages and have that each of the four stages run all at the same time, you need somewhere about 4 million watts of power. So generally you'd have to have a pretty good power system to do that. Conversely, you'd need one engine and one gearbox and manually have to switch the gears back and forward. But if you have an automatic redstone to flip back and forward, the clutch system would be able to help you essentially divert power to a gearbox that would up the torque to give you that 512, or conversely change it direction and input into a gearbox that would give you the higher radiance that you need to run the machine. And so I think I'll be doing that probably next episode maybe. Nothing that's a bit today, guys. If you've got any questions, let me know. Hit that like button if you like it, always helps. And subscribe if you want to see more of this stuff. Until next time, guys. Ready.